Welcome students. Today we will discuss the chapter motion. This chapter is of class 9th and this is the concept map for the chapter motion. So we have divided motion chapter into different sub parts. So the first part motion is divided is distance and displacement. So motion is change in position. And further change in position leads to distance and displacement. This is the first part. The second topic we will discuss in this chapter is rate of motion. As the motion changes with time, it leads to the first point is speed. We will discuss about speed. Second is velocity. And the third is acceleration. As it is very clear that speed is distance upon time, it includes distance. That we have the first discussed about this. Then velocity is displacement upon time. And the third topic of this is acceleration, which is change in velocity upon time. So we will discuss about distance displacement and then we will discuss about speed, velocity and acceleration. Then after these two, we will discuss about the types of motion. These are the types of motion. The first one is uniform motion. The second is non-uniform motion and the third one is circular motion. So one by one in this chapter we will discuss about these things. So let us discuss about first distance and displacement. So the motion means the movement of an object from one place to another with respect to its origin is called motion. Here origin refers to the position of observer or any reference point. For example, here we can see that the object is moving from, my marker is moving from point A to point B. So the object marker is in motion. As you are the observer watching in this video, you are at a particular point. We can consider it as origin or a reference point. So again, I'll recall what is motion. Motion is the movement of an object that is from point A to point B, from one place to another with respect to its origin. So you are watching at a particular place, you will be considered as a reference point or a origin. So next we will discuss about distance and displacement. So the distance is length of path. The distance means length of a path. So as we are very familiar with the term distance, its SI unit is meter, though it is being calculated in kilometer, centimeter, but the standard unit for distance is meter only. Next thing is displacement. Displacement is the shortest distance between initial and final position of an object. So again, the SI unit of displacement is meter. One more thing you have to note it down, that displacement has direction, whereas distance is just a random value, it's a normal value, but displacement we are dealing with the numeric value plus the direction. So let us understand this concept of distance and displacement with the help of an example. So you are going from home to a park by traveling a lot of path and finally you reach this park. So this overall path you covered is called the distance. This is the distance you covered to reach this park from your home. So this is the overall path. Now what displacement is? This is your initial point. I am writing it as initial position IP. And park is your final position. I am writing it as FP. So this is your initial position and this is the final position. What displacement means is the shortest distance between initial and final position. So from home to park, the shortest distance is this straight line. This is a very simple line, straight line, which leads from home to the park. And this straight line is called as this straight line and the shortest distance is called as displacement. If you want to calculate the displacement, just place a straight line between your initial and final position and you can calculate that path. That will be your displacement. we can consider it with an example that you are moving in, you have moved 40 kilometers in northeast direction. So here we include distance as well as direction. So distance with direction is called displacement. So next we will discuss about scalar and vector quantities. So after distance and displacement, we will now discuss scalar and vector quantities. It is a very important topic. And what scalar quantities are? Scalar quantities are those quantities which have only magnitude but no direction. It has only magnitude. It is magnitude means a value. So scalar quantities have only magnitude but no direction. For example, distance, speed, and mass. As you are very familiar with the term distance, distance can be like 10 kilometers, 20 kilometers, 30 kilometers. It is only a simple value. So in distance, we are not discussing about any direction. So those quantities in which we will discuss only about the magnitude, they are called as scalar quantities. Next are vector quantities. Vector quantities are those quantities which have both magnitude as well as direction. So remember, we have discussed a term which have a distance as well as direction. That quantity was displacement. Yes, displacement, velocity, and force. These are the quantities. Some other quantities are also there, but these are the quantities: displacement, velocity, and force, which have both magnitude as well as direction. Let us consider an example that a person is traveling from Amritsar to Chandigarh. So a person is moving from point A to point C. It has to cover 10 kilometer distance. It has to cover 10 kilometer distance and as well as it is moving in southwest direction. So this includes some distance as well as direction. So here it is a vector quantity which include both magnitude. This is the magnitude. 10 kilometer is the magnitude and direction is southwest. So this quantity is called vector quantity. If it includes only the distance that a person covers, a person goes from point A to C and covers 10 kilometer distance without any direction. So in that particular case, it will be considered as a scalar quantity. So with this, we are clear with the topic distance and displacement, scalar and vector. Now we will solve a numerical based on distance and displacement. So this is the numerical which says Rocky completes one round of circular track with radius 50 meter. So Rocky completes a circular track which has a radius of 50 meters in 2 minutes. One round Rocky completes in 2 minutes. You have to find the distance covered in 8 minutes and the displacement after 8 minutes. So let us note down all the things that Rocky starts from point A. It covers one round in 2 minutes. This is the radius of the circular track that is given, 50 meters. We have already noted down. To complete one round, it takes 2 minutes. So this is the one round. The total time we have to calculate the distance covered in 8 minutes. So in total 8 minutes, how many round Rocky will covered? How many rounds Rocky will take? So in total 8 minutes, Rocky will complete 4 rounds. So as for one round, it takes 2 minutes, 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. Again, it comes to be total 4 rounds in 8 minutes. So to find the total distance, we will use the formula 2 pi r into number of rounds covered. 2 pi r is the formula for perimeter of circle. So perimeter 2 pi r into total number of rounds covered in particular 8 minutes. So that will be 4. You will put the value of r, that is the value of radius we have already noted down. 2 pi into 50 multiply by the number of rounds. Then by solving these, we will get 400 pi. We are already very familiar with the value of pi, that is 3.14. By substituting this value over here, we will get the total distance that has come out to be 1256 meters. So after 4 rounds, the total distance comes out to be 1256 meters. See the units, the unit of the distance is meters. Now what about displacement? We know that the rocket starts from point A and again after 8 minutes, it ends at point again at A. So the initial point and the final point are the same. So recall, we have discussed about displacement, the shortest distance between initial and final position. So in this case, in this particular case, the initial and the final point is A. So the overall displacement will be zero. So this is your example for the distance and displacement related numericals. I'll share some more numericals on this particular topic. If you have any queries regarding this topic, till we have done, you can just drop down your queries in the comment section and I'll try to solve and try to answer all the queries. Okay, thank you. This is it for now. Stay safe, stay home, students. Take care.